G'day YouTube, my name is Reinhard, this is My Personal Finance, and in today's video, we're going to chat about Investec Bank. So, what is Investec Bank, and why did I choose Investec Bank? I moved my banking to Investec, and you guys would say I'm a hypocrite. Well, I'm not. I'll put a link here from the other videos that I did about other banks. I've done a few of them. I've done on Discovery, Capitec, Virgin Money, FNB, eBlocks. I've done a few. So I actually did a lot. So you can go check them out. Tell me what you think about them. The reason why I went with Investec and why I changed my banking to Investec is they are the top dogs when it comes to lending for loans. Buying a house, buying a car, I bought a flat, so yeah, I got by far the best rate with them. I got prime minus, I think 0.6. I can't tell you how happy I was to get it, and I got pre-approved with them, no money down, I didn't have to put any deposit down. I got the good interest rate, and because of the good interest rate, I could get more on the loan amount. The capital amount I got was actually quite high, because remember, the lower the interest rate, the lower amount of premium you have to pay every month, the higher the bond amount you can qualify for. So that makes Investec all the worthwhile. I mean, I put a few things here that I think is great. Let's quickly run through them. You get a personal banker. Maybe it's not what it's made out to be. Maybe it is. It's a person you only contact what you need. You don't speak every time with someone else. You speak with this person. They help you with whatever you need. So you get a personal banker. You get a credit card at prime. This is a big thing for a lot of people. It's also nice to have credit card at prime, house loan at prime minus. That is very good. I mean, that made my day. Yeah, I got a good interest rate. I can't complain here. One's a fee of $2.95 per month if you're under 30, and $4.95 if you're above 30. I know it is quite expensive, but go look at Discovery Bank, go look at FNB Bank, go look at the other APSA, whoever. They all have similar type of offerings. That's the credit card and the debit card included. And actually with Investec you save, because they don't charge you extra on the amounts for your home loan. So, and I mean, it's a once-off fee. You don't pay any other fees, no hidden fees, no nothing. It's a once-off $2.95 or $4.95. They've got high interest savings account of 6.5. This was before the interest rates came down. So just check, it's not the same anymore now because it's linked to interest rates. They've got things like Investec Travel. You can book tickets through them. You can do a hire car through them. It works quite well. I've done some of them. They've got another thing people like these days, Investec Rewards, but it's on all your purchases. That's why it works better for me than eBucks, because eBucks makes you go to certain places. You can only shop here, you can only earn your eBucks here, you can only spend your eBucks there. Investec Rewards, you can basically earn rewards anywhere. You earn your rewards anywhere and you can basically spend them anywhere, because you can get a voucher at the mall, and it's most malls, and you can use the voucher at any shop inside the mall. So yeah, what else do you want? You can convert it into vouchers. The big thing for me was the pre-approval for first-time home buyer without any deposit. I mean, that's huge. Okay, so the last one is also add-on service. I don't use it. You can open an offshore banking account in Great Britain. It's in sterling pounds, and you can, if you live in England half of the year, you can have that dual account. I don't use it at all. I don't need it. So guys, that's a quick summary of Investec. I must say it's really nice. I'm very happy with the bank so far. Yes, it is expensive. It is difficult to get in, but when you get in, it's definitely worth it. So these guys do a full financial analysis of your debts and your equities and everything you have. and they want to see if you'll be able to pay their money back if you make loans from them. I must say, if you're first in, then it's easier to get loans and so on from them. So tell me, guys, what do you think? Do you like Investec? Do you like Discovery Bank? Do you like FNB, Absa, Standard Bank? Which one do you like? Tell me in the comments down below. Have a great day. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.